Yes, he's the Prime Minister of Singapore, Lee Hsien Loong! Lee Hsien Loong, Dong Suan! Lee Hsien Loong, Dong Suan! Hello everyone, I'm here not just to talk about Tsai Ing-wen, but also the Prime Minister of Singapore, Lee Hsien Loong, as well as a new young man, Chan Tong-Kai, the big murderer of Taiwan. Since the Hong Kong protest, we have seen a huge bump in voters supporting Tsai Ing-wen for the next presidential election.
The Taiwanese suddenly rose up to support her for democracy and freedom, as well as showing sympathy for Joshua Wong.
When he keeps on advocating about Hong Kong independence.
Now it's time for the Hong Kong government to investigate police brutality.
And also, Dennis Ho.
My name is Dennis Ho. I'm a singer and pro-democracy activist from Hong Kong.
Because of these two idiots, Tsai Ing-wen is so wild about it. That give her an opportunity to advocate her kind of rejection of one country, two system policy against China. And she did that to gain public support. FYI, there's no such thing as one country, two system in Taiwan. Because Taiwan is not a country, but Republic of China is. One country, two system is only applicable for ROT. Republic of Taiwan, if you want to name it. ROT. ROT. That's funny. ROT. Taiwan is not a country, but ROC is. And ROC is China. Got it? To have ROC with one country, two system, unless, over my dead body.
台湾人民怎么可能接受香港澳门的一国两制？除非 over my dead body， 好不好？
韩国瑜动算，韩国瑜动算，韩国瑜动算，韩国瑜动算，动算韩国瑜。 I just learned this a few days ago in the rally. A bit energetic and excited. As a matter of fact, Taiwan is China. And this is why we call ROC, Republic of China. PRC and ROC are China itself. Therefore, there was
no,
there is
no,
and there will not be one country, two system in ROC. And Taiwan is totally different from Hong Kong. Hong Kong is just a province. Therefore, Tsai Ing-wen is just confusing and misleading the people, and she's just adding fuel to the situation in Hong Kong. Look at our world hero!
Whom am I referring to?
Yes, he's the Prime Minister of Singapore, Lee Hsien Loong! Lee Hsien Loong, Dong Suan! Lee Hsien Loong, Dong Suan!
Which are meant to be a program to solve Hong Kong's problems. Those are demands which are intended to humiliate and bring down the government.
Okay, this time I'm on his side because what he said made a lot of sense and 100% like a human being. Well, Tsai Ing-wen, she's not a human being, but a pig in the damn pig party. Normally, I don't agree with Lee Hsien Loong, but this time I will. Because he's doing for the sake of the world and for world peace and the truth. And I take my hat off to him. He's looking at the global perspective. And this was what Tsai Ing-wen should learn from him totally. Lee Hsien Loong mentioned that the five demands created by Joshua Wong are intended to humiliate and bring down the Chinese government, of which what he said is totally right. Perfect. In this regard, it is very, very brave of him to say these things against the Hong Kong protesters, despite there are some Hong Kong people staying in Singapore. Not only that, I want to add on that the Hong Kong protesters are bringing a disgrace to all people in Taiwan if they are sharing the same sentiment with Tsai Ing-wen. This is because Tsai Ing-wen is lying to the people that Taiwan will face the same situation as Hong Kong if it were a one country, two system policy. As a matter of fact, she's trying to tell the whole world that ROC is not an independent country. It's not China. Because of what the Chinese government is doing. The truth is we cannot mix Hong Kong and Taiwan together. Both of them are totally different. Of which you are comparing apple with an orange. Hong Kong is just a name of an island and is a province way before the British colonization. While Taiwan, although it's a name of an island too, is ROC, a country of China. ROC and PRC are China, while Hong Kong and Macau are under PRC. PRC plus ROC equal to China. Therefore, there's no such thing as one country, two system in Taiwan, unless you call it as ROT, not ROC. ROC and PRC are China. There is always one government taking care of ROC and one government taking care of PRC. One is a communist, but one is a democratic, and there's no overlapping between them at all. If you're still confused, just think of North Korea and South Korea. But they are both Koreas. DPRK and ROK have its own government. But the North Korea and the South Korea are called Korea. Got it? Similarly for China, one is PRC and one is ROC under one China principle. So we could say one is East China and one is West China to become China. Bingo! Yes, am I smart? Wow! Bingo! This is the theory. Getting copyright. Whereas for Hong Kong, it's just part of China and it's a province under PRC government. Therefore, the five demands that Joshua Wong mentioned are totally ridiculous and abomination. Hong Kong people should not think that Hong Kong is two systems, but think it as one country. Yeah, Lee Hsien Loong, Dong Zhuan. Lee Hsien Loong is right in his mind in fostering good relationship with the Chinese government, which totally contrasts to Tsai Ing-wen, whose ambition is only trying to win her presidential seat. People are working together to improve their economy, while Tsai Ing-wen is ironically shouting for democracy, freedom and independence. This is just a waste of time and waste of taxpayer money to pay her for doing all this nonsense. The Hong Kong protesters have become the rioters, and they should be punished for what they have done. The rule applies the same for Chan Tong-Kai. He should be punished for his crime of murdering his girlfriend. And the extradition bill is very important to make sure that justice is served. Do you know who's the happiest person to see Hong Kong in such a mess right now? It's none other than Tsai Ing-wen. Tsai Ing-wen, Lord die. Tsai Ing-wen, Lord die. Right? The worse Hong Kong get, the happier Tsai Ing-wen will be. Because he's trying to delude the people to make sure they have a negative impression of the Chinese government, while at the same time abusing democracy and freedoms and independence to gain her popularity for the upcoming election. If the protest in Hong Kong keeps on growing and with more violence, it will give her an advantage to stir the Taiwanese to hate the mainland China. And this is what she's gonna do. She's a big troublemaker. If Hong Kong is at peace with the mainland, her position as a president will be very unstable, and she may even get impeached. In this connection, her aim is to see the Chinese government to send its liberation army to attack the Hong Kong protester, so that she could convince the Taiwanese about the Chinese government handling the matter. Her plot is very evil, because she has placed her ambition more important than the life of the people, including the girlfriend of the murderer. And this is the reason why she didn't accept Chan Tong-Kai when he volunteered to come into Taiwan. She gave a lame excuse that he and the girlfriend are not the Taiwanese, even though the crime was committed in Taiwan, in Taipei. Even so, Tsai refused him to enter unless Hong Kong agreed to offer comprehensive judicial and full legal cooperation in the case. Oh no! And she even asked Hong Kong to provide all relevant evidence to Taiwan. Evidence? What evidence is she talking about? The evidence all is in Taiwan, because the murder is committed in Taiwan, in Taipei itself. And she requests evidence from Hong Kong. That is preposterous. Chan strangled his girlfriend in the hotel room in Taipei and then put her dead body in a suitcase and dump it in Taipei. Okay, everything is in Taipei, all evidence, whatever things, belongings, dead body, hotels, and everything, whatever evidence is in Taipei. And yet, she's requesting evidence from Hong Kong. Or is she having a dementia? She's just giving a lame excuse not to accept Chan so that the protest in Hong Kong could carry on. And she's hoping to see the violence could pressure the Chinese government. In the end, this would only cause bloodshed in Hong Kong. Not only there is no justice for the girl, but also more lives are going to lose in Hong Kong. All these are because of her. She is a mass murderer. Tsai Ing-wen is a mass murderer. Just because of her election, she is very evil and let the criminals to go scot-free. That means I could go to Taiwan and kill someone and then go back free? Taiwan has become a place for committing crimes, whereas Hong Kong a place for harboring criminals. That is totally insane. It is what you call justice? Oh my god! What has Taiwan turned into? Anyway, Chan Ing-wen, Lok Tai, Han Kuo-yu, Dong Suan. I hope you enjoy my show and please subscribe, like and share my video. See ya, bye bye.